Paperboy, Sub Shops, Opus Number 1, Casablanca. Growing Up During World War II by Gordon Grigsby. The Hurricane, Robin Hood, and the Bounty for John Hall, Errol Flynn, Clark Gable. You're looking down into a dark pit-like cell and can't tell what you're seeing. Then he looks up and you see only eyes, the whites of those eyes. His skin is dark. He's been imprisoned by Raymond Massey, evil colonial governor, and in the opening you've seen him dive from the top of the mast of a fishing schooner into the island lagoon and swim toward Dorothy L'Amour. His men hiding in the trees have shown themselves surrounding wicked Lord Basil Rathbone and the horseback column of a king's men ordered into the forest by smoky-voiced Claude Rains back in the castle, when he swings down on a vine to a fallen tree and stands there laughing. With that perfect frown, is it after the keel hauling? I don't remember. He turns at last away from the rail, white blouse-like shirt rippling lightly in the wind, and stops Lawton's wonderfully horrible Captain Bligh from flogging another man, and you know the mutiny has begun. With these images burned into your mind at 9 and 10, how can you go wrong? Easy, of course, but still, what lovely things they did for a kid in the 30s.